Regardless of the industry you are working for, as a member of the finance community of your organization, you recognize the peak in the workload during the period and closing routine. A couple of days doing tedious tasks that require absolute accuracy, while at the same time, the time pressure is getting higher and higher. As we were engaged in an upgrade project to SAP S4HANA release 2023 several months ago, we came across some new Fiori tiles containing the ability to carry out the validations that are normally being carried out by you and your colleagues. If you are interested in how SAP S4HANA can do checks on the figures for you, instead of doing it yourself, then watch the rest of this video. My name is Suzanne van Groos, and I have joined McCoy and Partners at the end of 2023. I'm working as an SAP Finance and Controlling Consultant with about a decade of experience in this field. The new functionality that I'm about to demonstrate to you makes life of the finance department easier. Because every month, before we close the books and are about to report on the figures, we must make sure that the figures are correct, complete, and in time. How do we check this? By comparing one figure to another. Figures we retrieve from our balance sheet and the profit and loss statement in SAP. Some examples. Did we post the accruals? Is the accumulated depreciation less than the original acquisition value? Did suspense account XYZ have a zero balance? Is there a significant rise in operational or out-of-pocket expenses? For every validation we take care of, we note the results, we scribble some notes, and we document and store the evidence. One of the new functionalities in SAP S4HANA release 2023 is balance validations. With this feature, you can make SAP do this kind of work for you. It is presented by SAP S4HANA to you with these three Fiori tiles. It's time for action. I've started up my Fiori Launchpad, and let's start with scheduling a validation run. We will begin by clicking on this app to schedule the job. And this will lead to an overview of all the jobs. For now, it's just one. And we will press create to create a new job. In the first step, we can select a template, give our job a name. And in the second step, we have the possibility to schedule the job. We can start it immediately or schedule it at a later time. We can define recurrence patterns to make sure that we only have to schedule just this job once. You can choose to schedule it monthly, daily, weekly, whatever suits your needs. But for now, we will just start a job immediately and only run it once. In the next step, we can set the parameters. So we can choose to run the job for one specific company code, or maybe we would like to do it for a set of company codes. And we can do the same thing for profit centers or cost centers. At the right side of the screen, we have to set the parameters for our job. We can choose a group of rules. So this group consists of validation rules. Let's select one ledger. Pick a currency. This can be, for example, the company code currency. And we have to specify a fiscal year and period for this job. And if we are done, we can hit check to see if we entered everything we need. And if so, we can go ahead and schedule the job. In the overview, you see two jobs. The one we just created is now also on the screen. And let's have a look at the details of this job. In this screen, you can see the log and the results, and we can also see that our job has ended successfully. Now, that wasn't too difficult, was it? And don't forget that if you make this action a recurring job, you'll even save more time. Let's take a look at the results of the validation we have scheduled a moment ago. Let's select the app to view the results of the validation. This will bring us to a screen with an overview of all the runs, with the latest one on top. We will select this one, our one. And by default, you can see that the successful validations are not displayed. So we have to adjust the filter to show all of them. We can expand or collapse the hierarchy to show or hide part of the validations within this group. And if you like, you can click on the rules to see the formula that was used. At the right side of the screen, you can see the results of the calculation and whether the validation was successful or not. Let's have a look at the details for one of the rules. Here you can see the formula again and also the amount that the system has calculated. Let's close this one for now and have a look at another rule. Again, the formula is showed, including the calculated amounts, and we also have the possibility to add a comment. When setting up the rules, we can specify whether adding a comment is mandatory or not. Let's expand the hierarchy again to show all validations. And as you can see, all checks were carried out by SAP, not by you. And the only thing you have to do is check the results. You are probably curious about what is behind this way of working. In other words, where did SAP S/4HANA get the figures from? Well, the validations we carried out were just examples. To make it work for you, you need to pick up your internal controls and translate them into the tool. This is where the app Manage, Balance, Validations and Groups kicks in. You have to set up your validation rules. And remember, you don't have to start from scratch. There is a set of validations to inspire you. I'll demonstrate what we set up to make our validation stick. Let's open the third app to set up the rules. And this will lead to a screen showing groups and rules. And the groups are actually a set of rules. And the rules are based on a standard set delivered by SAP. We will have a look at the group we've used. And in this group, you see the two nodes that we saw before. So one for the balance sheet and one for the P&L. Let's close this one for now and move over to the rules. As I mentioned, these are based on a standard set that is delivered by SAP. And if we go into the details, we will see everything that's behind this rule. So there's an ID and also a description. We can set the tolerance level. For this rule, it's set to 0. And we can specify whether the system should give an error or a warning when this validation was carried out. At the bottom of the screen, you will see the formula that is used to, in this case, compare current assets to current liabilities. And we are stating that the current assets should be greater than or equal to the current liabilities. Well, let's have a look at how the formula was built up to calculate the current assets. It consists of four different expressions, and one of them is the account receivables. Well, this is an absolute amount, and it's the sum year to date for a specific set of GL accounts. So everything posted year to date to this specific set will be part of the total amount of account receivables. Besides using GL accounts, there is a possibility of using other parameters. Over here, you see a list of the different possibilities. What we could do, for example, is instead of entering a range of GL accounts, we could select a node or more nodes from the hierarchy. And we could do the same thing for cost centers. And this will mean that whenever a cost center or GL is added to your system and assigned to this node, it will be automatically included in your validation. So no more action needed in adjusting the validation rule. Let's cancel the changes we've made so far. And have a look at the simulate option, because we have the possibility to run a simulation of this rule. We have to enter some parameters like company code and the ledger, currency, so local currency, company code, currency, fiscal year, fiscal period, and then we can hit run to see the results of the simulation. As you can see on the left, the current assets are indeed greater than, on the right, the current liabilities. So this simulation was successful. And if we go back to the screen showing groups and rules, I'd like to show you one more thing. In case you want to test a new validation rule or move it from one system to another, you can use the export and import functionality. Export from one system and import into the other to make the rules for your internal controls available in the relevant system. If watching this video brought you new insights, then please hit the like button in your YouTube app. Or even better, share it with your finance peers in or outside your organization. If you want to see more month-end closing functionality, then the McCoy TV episode about advanced financial closing could be of interest to you as well. For now, I thank you for watching this McCoy TV about balance validations.